Hi everyone, I'm Andrew and I work on SwiftUI. I'm super happy to talk to you about working with Windows and your SwiftUI app. Windows are a container for the content of your app. A window allows people to manage parts of your app with familiar controls, like being able to reposition, resize, or close it. I'll be working on Botanist, a SwiftUI app my friends and I have been working on. Here in the simulator is the Botanist robot editor, where a robot can be customized. Players can bring this robot into a game where they help the robot tend to plants. Botanist has a tailored experience for iOS, iPadOS, visionOS, and macOS. The concepts I'll discuss apply to multi-window platforms. But in this video, I'll focus on visionOS. I'll talk about how to define, open, and use a window. I'll cover how to control the initial placement of windows, and I'll discuss the different ways windows can be sized. First up, the fundamentals. With individual windows, people can use different parts of your app at the same time. And having multiple instances of the same interface can be really powerful. People can use system controls to independently manipulate each window, like being able to resize, reposition, or scale it. And each window can take advantage of platform-specific features. For example, on visionOS, a window can contain 3D content by using a volumetric window style. While multiple windows are powerful, using a single top-level view, like a tab view, can simplify the experience. To learn more about tab view and other top-level views, check out Elevate Your Windowed App for Spatial Computing. To learn when multiple windows are appropriate in visionOS, check out Design for Spatial User Interfaces. Botanist has two primary scenes in visionOS: the editor window and the game volume. Each scene is defined by a window group. The app opens to an instance of the robot editor window group. And a button in this window opens an instance of the game window group. The volumetric window style makes this window a volume in visionOS. I'd like to add two new features to Botanist. The first will open a new window containing a movie made about the robot. The movie will be a 3D scene contained in a portal. In the app body, I add a new window group that contains the 3D scene view. To identify this window group, I've given it an ID of movie. I'll use this ID to open the window. I'll pass the ID to an environment action. These actions are available at any point in the SwiftUI hierarchy. A few different environment actions are available for managing windows. Use OpenWindow to open a window. To close a window, use DismissWindow. PushWindow can be used to open a window and hide the originating window. I'll use OpenWindow to open a new movie window. In the robot editor view, I retrieve an OpenWindow action from the environment by creating an environment property with a key path of open window. And then, within a new button, I can perform the open window action, passing in the ID I defined for the window group earlier, movie. Now, tapping the button in the editor opens the movie portal as a separate window. Now that I see it, I don't think the editor should be visible at the same time as the movie view. So I'll use the push window environment action to present the window instead. This will open the new window in place of the originating window. Closing the new window will result in the originating window reappearing. To hide the editor when opening the movie window, I change the environment property key path from open window to push window and update the button to call this action instead. Now, tapping the TV button will push the movie window and hide the robot editor window. Now, I can watch the robot I've designed begin their acting career without any distractions. Tapping the close button will take me back to the editor. No additional logic is needed to get this behavior. Consider using this action when showing content that doesn't need to be visible at the same time as the presenting window. With the windows defined and opened, they can now be enhanced to feel even more at home with platform-specific features. Like how Freeform uses a toolbar ornament to display controls along the bottom edge of a window. Or how a toolbar title menu presents actions related to a document without crowding the canvas. The window bar and close button are always visible by default. But for the movie view, I use the persistent system overlays modifier to hide these, to let people focus on the movie. These APIs are some great ways to enhance a window in visionOS. For refining a window in macOS, check out Tailor macOS Windows with SwiftUI. The movie window is looking great. Next, I'd like to add an optional control panel for the game. This panel will have additional controls for moving the robot and a few buttons to perform actions like jump or wave. I've added a new window group that displays the controls. And also an open window call in the game volume. Now, tapping the button in the game opens my controls in a new window. I like that they can be repositioned independently of the game volume. But when the window first opens, it covers the volume and might be positioned far away. VisionOS places new windows, like the control panel, in front of the originating window. macOS, on the other hand, opens new windows at the center of the screen. This behavior can be customized with the default window placement modifier. It allows the initial position and size of a window to be set programmatically. Depending on the platform, windows can be positioned and sized in a few ways. They can be positioned relative to other windows, like a leading or trailing position, relative to people with a position like utility panel in VisionOS, which places the window close by and generally within direct touch range, or relative to the screen, like the top right quadrant in macOS. To make the game controls appear close to the player in VisionOS, I applied the default window placement modifier to the controller window group. From this, I return a window placement with a position of utility panel. I wrap this return in an if condition so that this placement is only applied for VisionOS. Now the controls appear close by when the window is first opened, and the player is able to move the window from its initial placement if they like. Using these new controls, I'm able to interact with the robot in a whole new way. Like tapping this button to make the botanist wave. The controller window is looking great in VisionOS. Next, in macOS, I'll calculate a position for this window manually. The default window placement modifier provides a context. Depending on the platform, this will contain different information. In macOS, the context contains information about the default display. I access that and get the visible rect. This represents where it is safe to place content. Using the size that fits method, I ask the contents of the window what size they would like to be. Using the display bounds and size variables, I calculate a position that is just above the bottom of the display and centered horizontally. Now I can return a window placement with the calculated position and the size. Now my controls are positioned comfortably on macOS as well. While playing, the player is free to reposition the window or even place it on a separate screen. I'm loving these new window placements. To make sure my content is always looking its best, I'd like to change how the window can be resized as well. Windows have an initial size determined by the system. You can change the default size in a few different ways. If the size depends on the screen size or other windows, you can specify an initial size through the default window placement API. like I did for the controller window in macOS. Alternatively, you can use the default size modifier to change the initial size. Note that this default size is not used if there are other size constraints, like a size provided by the window placement API or when scenes are restored. For a pushed window, like the movie window I added earlier, the default size will be the same as the originating window's size. The originating window in this case is the robot editor. I'm happy with the default size, but players may want to resize the movie window. I'll set some limits so the movie always looks good. By specifying that the movie window group should have a window resizability of content size, the window will be limited to the min and max size of the content it contains. To the movie content view, I add a min and max width and a min and max height. Now the movie window can be resized down to a square and resized up within reasonable limits. I could watch The Botanist all day, but I should really focus on the controls window. It can be resized to be too large, getting in the way of the volume. It makes sense for the size of this window to match the size of the content it contains. Just like I did for the movie window group, I also add a window resizability modifier to the controller window group. Now, when I change the controller mode, the window resizes to match the size of the content. Note that this window is not resizable by the player, because the views for each mode have fixed sizes, not min and max sizes. Botanist is coming along really well. I've made some great improvements to the app for visionOS and macOS. Your app can also make great use of windows and the APIs that support them. Consider whether a window or a top-level view makes the most sense for your app. Use the Window Placement API to provide an initial layout. Size windows based on their content, and set limits on how a window can be resized. And make use of platform-specific window features to make your app feel even more at home. Thanks for joining me. I hope you enjoy working with Windows in your app.